Hi, I'm Mark Sutherland from Sutherland Presses. We're here today to expose you to the iPress AB Plus Press and Automation Control. It is by far and away the most intuitive, fully featured control on the market. And it also has an incredible feature of connected enterprise. And what does that mean to end users now and in the future? It means that they have the ability to extract data, download, monitor the press from mobile devices, download jobs from engineering to the press. So I'm going to give you a quick walkthrough on the control. This is the main run screen of the control. The iPress Easy Navigation button allows you to navigate through the press control quickly. We've had operators learn this control in less than 30 minutes and get to a high comfort level. Stroke position indicator, OK monitor. If you had a fault, it would show up here in the upper right. The operation section is what job you're on that's able to be named in 10-digit alphanumeric. What your speed is set for. Your mode is off inch, single, or continuous. Motor is in forward, flywheel, brake, or reverse. And the amp draw. The amp draw is a really cool feature because that allows users to set their counterbalance pressure based on the upper die weight of the press to equalize that so there's minimal motor fluctuation. The performance box is all for clutch brake related, so it's monitoring brake stopping time, clutch engagement time. There's six counters on the press. We're showing one up front, which is a preset or batch counter, and that'll run up to the desired amount of parts and then stop it after that amount has been hit. You also, in the lower right, have a maintenance counter, and that's set by the supervisor, so if they want to perform maintenance after a half a million hits, it'll stop the press. Special mode of operations is another feature set that we offer as standard, and that allows users to tie automation in where the press becomes slave to the automation. So single stroke on demand would be waiting for the device, external device or automation, to send a signal to the press before the slide would actually move. We've set it up where it's intuitive and we have two levels of operation. Level one operator is for all the primary functions of the press and controlling the press and the automation. And I'll give you a quick example of this. Job memory, this is where you'd enter a new job. In this case, we're on Sutherland 01. The speed is set for 40 strokes per minute. Die height is set for 350.3 millimeter. Upper die weight is 1,000 pounds, and your air counterbalance pressure is set for 2.8 bar. If you go to the cam screen, they've all been named when the press was received by the end user and wired in. So as an example, air ejector, feed advance, pilot release, coil lube, easy to turn on and off, easy to change the angle of display. Die monitoring, you've got 16 channels of die monitoring. And again, once they're wired into the system, example, part out detect, scrap out detect, die monitor 1, 2, 3. You can turn the switch on or off. You can change it from cyclic to contact. You can change it from normally open to normally closed, and the type of stop you want. If you want a cycle stop, you'd switch to cycle and it'll stop immediately and leave the main motors running. If you changed it to top stop, it after it received its fault, it would go back to the top of the stroke and stop at top dead center. And the on angles and off angles. Tonnage. This is a 4-point press that we're showing you today. We also have them in 2-point presses for smaller gap frame and single point straight sides. The tonnage monitor is really set up, and it's set up based on each job. So you're getting a total tonnage reading, a reverse tonnage reading, a left rear, left front, right rear. And in the yellow boxes, you're able to set the high and low limits. So if you've got a left rear corner set for 20 tons, and you want the low limit to be set for 18 tons, if a punch breaks and the tonnage goes down, that's gonna stop the press and give you a fault on the main run screen. Same for the high limits. So right now we've got it set for 15. If you went over and exceeded 15 tons, it would stop the press, and that might be from slug buildup, scrap buildup in the die, and you'd be able to protect the die. Network configuration, we're using the latest in Rockwell components. We're using the Compact Guard Logix dual safety PLC, which is Ethernet connected, which is part of the Connected Enterprise. We're using the latest panel view screen. I'm going to show you in a minute some of the areas that we're developing that for on-screen maintenance 3D drawings. Your VFD PowerFlex Rockwell drive, which laptop is plugged in, and the IO safety modules. Job library. So it's as easy as once a job's been programmed into the control, you click fastener, hit select, back to your main run screen, and you're on the new job. And the press sets itself up, back to level one operator. CAM status. CAM and die monitor status are fields for the operator to look at but not adjust. So as you can see, this is a viewing field only. Die monitor status, same thing, viewing only. Counter screen, we've got six counters on the press. Preset one can be used as a batch counter, and that's shown on the main run screen. And that'll stop after you put in, if you want 100 parts, and turn it to the on position, it'll run up to 100 parts and stop when it has reached that. Preset counter two is an accessory counter. Cut counter one and cut counter two can be used for all types of auxiliary devices. It can be used as a counter. It could also be used based on the name cut counter, where if you have a scrap shear at the end of the progressive die as the material's coming through, maybe you don't want to cut that scrap every time. So if you want to wait four strokes and then get the material and then cut, so it gives you the ability to regulate when you want that to go active. You have a maintenance counter, which is the set value, the countdown as it's approaching the set value. And then you have a total life counter, which is exactly that. One of the guys from Pacific Blue is offline right now, and he's on his mobile device. And I'm going to ask him, Lionel, would you take us to about the About iPress? So this is an example of how you can monitor the press from remote devices. If you would, Lionel, take us to the press manual and the PDF document. And again, this is a vision that we have of how to make the press more user-friendly and less intimidating for the end user, the operators, the setup men. Now, this is a good example. So cautionary is for presses, whether it be off-center loads, blanking and reverse tonnage, air counterbalance. Those are the three main areas on a press that do not get taken care of well. And again, the goal is to make this an educational control for operators on the floor. This is an article on dealing with reverse tonnage. Reverse tonnage is one of the most damaging things to a press. Presses are designed, and the drive in the press is designed for forward tonnage. But when you're doing blanking operations, the reverse snap-through tonnage is what damages the press. And to add insult to injury, if the operators haven't set the air counterbalance correctly, you're effectively going to get reverse tonnage snap through type loads in your connection. Air counterbalance 101. So we have seen in the industry, 2016 represents our 70th year in business. We've installed thousands of machines, and one of the biggest culprits in press damage is from the improper use of air counterbalance capacity. So we've got informative information here. Again, teaching the operator to operate the press within its capacity limits. A mechanical press has an energy curve, and the energy is stored in the flywheel, which delivers to the slide motion up and down. if you look at the green zone here, you're within the curve. The red zone, you're outside of the curve, to pay attention to operating within the limits. Hydraulic overload. And again, these are just examples of where we're going with the manuals on screen. So this basically gives you a snapshot of the press control, like we're looking at here, to the overload pump and tank and its functionality. Another thing that we're developing at Sutherland for the iPress AB Plus is to give visual aids to the operator and maintenance people. And it will be more detailed than this when we're complete with the finished goods, but it will actually show the particular press, the 3D view, and all of the components that go with it. So fault history, fault diagnostics, and fault library. This is something that we've grown on the iPress as well. So fault history gives you a chronological when the fault occurred and when it was cleared. You can clear the faults. Fault diagnostics. If an operator's unsure of what the fault means, fault diagnostics gives sequential steps for an operator or maintenance personnel to go through what was the cause of the fault and the steps to check first, second, third, fourth to rule out what the problems are. You also have a fault library that the guys from PBE Engineering have designed for us. And we've broken it down so it's a little bit less challenging to look at. Fault groups: safety, motion, cams, tonnage, lubrication, and pneumatic. Then it gives you the fault code and you can drill back into the diagnostics. So that gives you an overview of what the operator has access to. Now when we go into, if we're logged in with the correct password as a supervisor, you have access to everything the operator has, plus you have access to main motor settings, lubrication settings, light curtains. You have the ability to mute those on the upstroke. You can have them always on if you were running progressive die. If you were running hand feed and you wanted to turn the lights off on the upstroke, maintenance counter, language selection. This is also being developed for most industrialized countries. Ejector cam, ejector dwell for cam 11 and 12. And what that would be for is if a customer had needed upper ejectors or lower ejectors to strip the part from the upper or lower die, we can actually set the dwell time in the case where the press returns back to the top of the stroke and you could wait a settable amount of seconds before that action would happen. Special modes of operation. Special modes of operation is something, again, that's standard on the iPress AB Plus. So right now we're showing we're in the normal mode, which is a traditional press, off, inch, single, and continuous. But if you want micro inch, and if any one of these are selected, it'll turn the other ones off, and it'll show that on the main run screen. So single on demand, and you have a timeout feature where you can program that event needs to happen within 10 seconds. So single on demand, as an example, would be used when a robot is feeding a part into the press and then removing the part after the stroke. So if the robot loaded the part, moved its arm out, then it would send a signal to the press to cycle and make one stroke. On many presses, you hit the reset button, and the Ross valve, which is one of the heartbeats of the press that control the clutch and brake, which control the slide motion, every time you hit the reset button on a control, there's no reason to be sending that 110-volt circuit into the Ross valve. So at a supervisor level, you can click it here and it's protected so the operators aren't doing that. Overrun reset and re-zero the encoder. So if the encoders and the digital display of where the press is in the stroke and the physical slide are out of sequence or out of synchronization, you can inch the press down to the bottom, follow these instructions, and reset or resynchronize the encoder. We also have, which is not accessible to the end user, these are for our technicians, the install date, the preventative maintenance date. And preventative maintenance is something that we are really seeing growing in the service side of our business. We know presses, we design presses, we build presses, and we like to take care of them like we build them. If you'd like more information on our green, yellow, red preventative maintenance programs, most of our customers, multi-shift customers, are doing it every 6 months. Single shift are doing it every year. So if you'd like to know more about the iPress AB Plus and the team and the presses that come with it, we encourage you to contact Sutherland. Thank you.